Okay, so the second game is coming from the match. This time it's going to be Anatolia. Frankly, that is probably home map for Shenanigans. I do remember him taking it before. He's gonna be continuing with his set on the other side. It will be Hagrit playing with Loki here. That maybe actually looks to me that he could be playing random god again. He likes to be doing that in tournaments. So wouldn't entirely surprise me. You're gonna be having to wait what happens in the third game. Because at least that one is gonna be played. Now the settings are best of 5. And Fog of 4 we want to be keeping. He's gonna be right now discovering the fishies. And kinda like knowing that he's maybe a bit unlucky. Yes, there's nothing there. 2 triplets. So not entirely choosing the correct side of the water, right? Yeah, well, of course, original maps can be spawning in this kind of variant and this kind of funny. Now, as for Hagrid to the top, he's gonna be at least seeing 1 triplet and he's gonna be having to hope it's gonna be slightly better than what Shenanigans is currently facing. At the same time, there could be easy switch to the other side. This is gonna be the second dock, or probably rather woodline first, yeah. Way too early for the second dock, of course. But he's also having nice food here, and maybe a bit surprising, he's gonna be trying to convert them, because it's very close to his granary, and therefore he could be getting basically the early start there, also a bit more powerful and faster, if he managed to get it from them. But I guess he just wants to be getting the army, and will be readying himself for some maybe early shifting sense in these against the Norse. Could be case, by the way, there's a triplet there. Oh well, Shenanigans going really quickly for him. Right for the jugular. And damn. No. That's gonna be actually quickly stolen. So if Hagrid is not gonna be having too many fish here to the back. But there probably should be one extra triplet. No, but should be. It's kinda nice to think. But then we see what actually happened to the bottom. It doesn't have to be too much true. So of course on the other side it's gonna be a decent spot for a dock. For Shenanigans himself. You can see discovering 2 of them here. So possibly somewhere in the middle. It's gonna be a possibility. But otherwise, the gold mines, you can see one is gonna be completely safe. Hagrid, of course, correct to be starting with the front one. As it doesn't like matter too much for him, because he's gonna be facing literally just the shift in sense. And it's gonna be the part that he's gonna have to be worried about in the early stages. Kinda like him, by the way, the cliff together with the wood line, like a natural wall through the whole map. It'd be really helpful for Shenanigans in the early stages, and he can be also starting on a good gold, but it's also well protected by the towers, and the back one is gonna be similarly cool with also a tower right next to it, and also very easy walling if it's gonna be needed. Some kind of short one there. Doesn't exactly matter if he's gonna be cutting off the TC, because obviously he can be getting there quite soon and quite easily anyway. So it seems like it unfortunate that the animals are going to be at this point disrupting the second dock from Hagrid. So while he did commit right now to the top side, he's gonna be having 1, 2 and in the end partially the third one here as well. And I'm currently seeing if there's gonna be something more, but to the right side, 1, 2, 3, 1, we don't see anything here. So it's gonna be second and third, you're gonna be having to wait for a bit longer for that. And we do see some first relic, which is gonna be Skills of Catoplepas, which is probably not gonna be helping too much in the early parts of the game here. That's gonna be actually kinda nice spy here for Hagrid, because he's gonna be there for no win when the opponent is gonna be ready for the shift in sense. So unless Shenanigans is gonna be anticipating that the actually spy is there, then it's gonna be really easy for Hagrid to see when he needs to be careful, as he's already dropping the temple. And it's gonna be so far only animals. I'm just waiting if maybe the Willy's coming forward somewhere. So far not, but maybe somewhere down the line. He's gonna be wanting to join there onto the second water as well to improve his overall chances on the early game. And of course, even on the later one, because, yeah, well, Egyptians are well set up to be controlling both waters with not entirely too much of a high effort, especially in 1v1. So is there another fish here or not? Maybe kinda have a look. Yeah, there is. Yeah. Yes, there is. But unfortunately, I'm thinking that Hagrid thought this is actually his. This is supposed to be his, and therefore these are the 3 fishies. So therefore there are 6 as they should be, but they are really quite a bit skewed towards the top side of the map. And how was it happening, and how was it looking rather to the bottom? Yep. All 6 fishies. Just of course a bit funny spawned. Finally spawned with village already here for the dog. No, and that's something that you need to be adjusting to from Age of Mythology, Titans and the balance match maps. Because those are way more reliable. Whereas here on Vanilla, even on the expert patch that this tournament is played upon, the maps are mostly the original spawns, how they actually were coded by the developers. Only certain small things were changed. I think that Midgard fish were improved, and also that you cannot be getting, for example, berries around the gold mine, which tend to be a thing, or that tended to be a thing on the original maps, and was prevented, of course, efficiency, because you needed to be gathering from them first, as they could not be removed in any kind of way. Oh, well, we're going for double temple build here for Forsetti 513. Okay, Shenanigans, let's go in here. Therefore, he's gonna be advancing through Anubis, expecting some hefty water fight. But to be honest, I don't think that Hagrid is too ready for that. I don't think he's gonna be doing it too much. As you can see, 55. And Doc is gonna be ready. And there was a wolf, you said? Or what happened? Right about now, a villager is gonna be... Ah, yeah, you mean actually this, the four wolfies here. Yeah, that certainly is quite a bit annoying. But he can be, of course, building a dock right now with the fishing boat, so not much of a problemo in the end. But did he actually lose the village here, or did he send it back? No, it's all the way here to the bottom. He's gonna be apparently just controlling the whole water himself. But yeah, there's nothing going on here. Just some few cabinets. Gonna be very easy for Shenanigans to control this part of the map. Even though maybe not so much, because Hagrid is coming up. Maybe a bit surprisingly with second dock. Because it so far seemed like he wants to be really going only for the land. Even dropping Longhouse to be ready for some throwing Axemen moves probably. Just to be helping against the enemy Axemen that might be coming up. So this is up. But he's getting... Okay, so he's gonna be having three longbows there. Another one here. But I'm having a bit of a feeling it might be already a bit too late. Because in Titans, sure, it'll be fine. He'll be able to shoot by the dock and not allowing therefore Shenanigans to pass by him too much. But here, yeah, it's gonna be a whole lot harder. Vanilla water is all about the numbers. Especially since all the boats are also the same. So not like an increased attack as you have in Titans. Nope, everything is absolutely the same and therefore only numbers. And your maneuvering capabilities are what matters. That's all that matters here. So let's switch into Shenanigans to have a look, because at this point, since he's having even the second water and he's right now spamming the fishing boats like mad, he could be having a good chance on rather prompt heroic. And then therefore controlling the middle of the map. By the way, he's having very good gold mines here to the right, very close to his base. That's really quite a lucky spawn for him. And if you're gonna be looking at it overall, there's next one in the middle. Last one is gonna be, I don't know where, somewhere in those two places. But yes, this is quite a good spawn. And I think Shenanigans is gonna be quite a bit thrilled. He was so blessed by the gods. Now, okay, so animals obviously won't be too effective against Hersiers, but nonetheless, they're also not gonna be too terrible. So if you're gonna be adding a few Axemen into the mix, it's gonna be already quite a bit of a different story. But the Valkyrie right now spawn would be liking a bit more INAR. But even the Valkyrie is nice. And but this was all about buying a bit of time for Shenanigans to get some more army going. Because while the Axemen are quite quickly made, they take only 10 seconds. Still, you need to be spending that time, of course, to get there. They are not gonna be instant, and he, of course, started only now for that. On the water, we're gonna be at about 4 longbows against 6 cabinets. Right about now 5, it's of course decreasing. But with no shooting docks, and of course, numbers, as we just mentioned, being the crucial part, it's gonna be quite a clear way how this is going. But he needs to be, of course, sending still some new boats, as maybe Hagrid is... I mean, like, it's not too surprising that he's actually trying to fight for that, because he's still feeling that it's not entirely that impossible to make it work. But problem is that Shenanigans doesn't have to be really pushing it that much. He can be effectively only just maybe faking the fight. He doesn't have to be playing it too much. And he's gonna be still having the right water to a pretty good degree. And at this point, this is basically just Hagrid. Not a bad idea to try to get the dog here, get a few longboats as well. But unfortunately, he needs to be choosing a bit different path. Or maybe drop it somewhere here, possibly. So it's gonna be a bit harder for Shenanigans to really block it in any kind of way. So Shenanigans, apparently Heroic Age is not coming. He's gonna be still with the resources quite a bit low. Hagrid is also not getting any kind of Heroic. Also not getting ready. No, and in the overall point of view, the top water is gonna be apparently done. He also casts the snake easier. Didn't even notice a bit earlier. Whereas well to the right, really, just the two cabinets probably at this point gonna be keeping Hagrid off. But with all the medium axemen that he got because of the nice ups that he could get from the food, that's what I wanted to say. Oh well, it seems like that Hagrid is already not too thrilled about the battle, and he's gonna be calling a quickie here, as the water is getting really out of hand for him. You can see right now to the top side, the situation is pretty much resolved. There's nothing he can be doing with that at that point. And here in the middle, there's already such an army, even if it's not only Hersiers. The Hersiers would be probably dying in the engagement here to the Axemen, because they really do have nice bonus and do kill them quickly. And therefore, with such a bonus on the economy, I guess that Hagrid is figuring out that there's not gonna be too much of a chance to really turn it around. Also based on the experience with the last game, where Shenanigans definitely proved to be quite a competent finisher. Okay, so that means that it's going to be 2-0, and quite a quick 2-0 at that. So I guess let's maybe have a look yet again into some where we got into Echo. You can see Hendax for the Loki. On the other side, maybe Pickaxe, even with the Hendax. And therefore time to be looking into the post game, which is yet again going to be clear victory for the Shenanigans. for Shenanigans rather. And his nickname. Can see right now there's gonna be 600 there, not even the stronger Norse economy at the start is gonna be covering for the difference of the water. You can see how much is it and how much it is. 1400 and 6, it's gonna be 800 more for Shenanigans already this early in the game. And of course the civilian 61, because he's simply having so many fishing boats on both sides of the map, so effectively like almost double the echo at the 9 minutes of the game. Pretty solid it is. And hey Top Noob, welcome to the stream. 33-44, like in the same numbers. Units lost also the same. So the Samos, and no, not much of a difference here. Can see Hagrid, it was a bit weird how we played the water. Not entirely certain if we expected that the water is not gonna be contested somewhat and thought it's gonna be fast and heroic, and therefore that's why he didn't even drop the second dock, or if he forgot, or I don't know. But if he started the water from the beginning, he shouldn't have been having too much of a problem to actually win it. Because here again, it's all about the numbers, and he should have been having higher ones. But nonetheless, he didn't, and therefore, GG.